Good afternoon from Okinawa, Japan, home of OkiSubies. Today, we are comparing some JDM heads to see which ones have the big port. And to inspect our JDM heads, we got our head inspector here, Dakota.
Hello.
And he's going to take a look at these ports and give us a complete unbiased which one he thinks is bigger. And then after he's done with that, I'll reveal what heads these actually are. All right? So, first things first. Dakota, go ahead.
Okay.
You can use the light. And what I would like for you to do is go through each port and just tell me from 1 to 4, right? This one being 1. And you just tell me, which one do you think has the biggest ports?
Okay.
That was a dirty one right there.
Yeah. So one from four?
Yeah, one from four. Let's go ahead.
So I would say this one right here.
This is the biggest one.
Yes.
Okay.
And let's see. I would say this one is the second biggest.
Second biggest.
This one is the third,
uh-huh.
And I think this is the fourth.
Okay.
To my opinion.
Let me ask you this question. Mm-hmm. Do you believe that this one, and this one, because it was a trick question, because I asked him which one's bigger. So he's going to automatically assume that they're bigger. Yeah. What if I told you, or what if I asked you, do you think that this, or this, is there actually a difference in the size, or is it a big enough difference for you to really say that this one, and this one? Is the size wise?
Well, to me, like these, so when I look inside, they all look sort of the same, especially when I look at the design. But to me, like I'm always, when I'm thinking like bigger, I always think like how deep it's either going or like this, like the size. That's what I thought of, because it does make it a little difficult when it's this dirty in there. But when I looked at this one, I thought it looked the smallest, because when I was looking at the first one I looked at, which was this one, I thought it was the biggest because of the biggest one, and it was going the deepest, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And this one I thought was the smallest because it had a smaller one, and it didn't go as deep in that, my opinion.
Right. So when you look at these ones right here, this one is a little bit more obvious right here, because these ones right here have a lot of lines, okay? This one is actually a CNC-ported head from an EJ257 going in Dylan's Forester STI. But if you look at the rib right here, you see this portion right here and this portion? These ribs compared to the EJ207 heads, right? Look at how you there's more material here even after ported. You get what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, I can see.
All this area right here, there's still more meat compared to this one right here. This middle spine, especially all the way up here, this one comes all the way up. This one has no material all the way over here, so there's more room on this backside also. Now, this area, all these areas, right, and this back portion, these ones here are clearly more bigger,
mm-hmm.
because they opened up the entrance way. But the backside and the rib in the middle, these ones here actually have more available. And these are stock. So you could imagine if we were to port these ones out in the same way in these areas, how it would be even bigger than these ones here, right? Does that make sense?
Yes.
So a ported EJ257 head versus... Now, this is, let's see, get your reaction on what heads these are, okay?
Okay.
This one is a version 7 STI head.
Okay.
This one is a version 8 Spec C head.
Oh. So would these be like, so in my opinion, would these heads like have different power outputs, and like would they be able to have more flow through them?
Right, and that's the big question. That's what everyone asks. They're asking, okay, well, what has the biggest port heads in EJ207 worlds, right? Does the version 7 have smaller heads than the version 8, let alone the Spec C setup, right? And that's essentially what we have here. And I'm looking at them. When I was looking at them, the reason why I wanted you to look at them is because I have kind of a presupposition, in the sense of I think they're the same. So if I already think that they're the same and I'm looking at, I'm going to kind of look for similarities. So I wanted someone else to look at them. And he's fighting over which one's actually bigger, which is telling you this. You would have to essentially pour some fluid inside of there and measure how much is going in there down to the CC to understand how much difference there is in size, right? It's not a huge difference. And then this one right here, if this is a version 7 STI and this is a version 7 Spec C, what would you guess that this dirty thing is?
I would guess it's a version 7, or I didn't know if they made like later ones, but
they got a version 9 one too, but it's okay. It's not a version 9.
Oh, so would this be a version 8?
A version 8. The funny thing is, guys, is this one right here is a EJ205 from a WRX.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh,
really? Right? That's crazy because the ports are so similar.
Yes.
And the funny thing is, if you look over here, it says LHS20V, right?
Yes.
It stands for left hand, and it's for the 20, right? The LHS that they have, a lot of the time, the speculation is that LHT20 is the Spec C head, which would work out because that's actually what is the Spec C right here. It shows the LHT20. This right here, you can see, is a B25 head, a left-hand side B25, which is EJ257 or EJ255 Forester. Mm-hmm. But if you look right here, what does that say right there?
LHT20.
LHT20. So this is an EJ205, and if you look on the interweb, it has the same marking that the Spec C has, right? So I would say that if the Spec C stamping and the EJ205 stamping, and then if you look at the size with the LHS20V, I think it's pretty safe to say that they're the same.
Basically,
right? They all have AVCS, so this is the AVCS solenoid.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the biggest difference. If we were to look at like a stateside EJ205, the ports would be a lot smaller than this.
Oh.
If you were to look at a B25 stock head before we CNC ported, it would be smaller than this.
Oh, okay.
And then if you were to also look at, we have legacy, like EJ20X setups, they're also smaller than this. So I'm not doubting the fact that the JDM EJ20s have big ports. I'm just saying some may already know. Some of them are like, that's what I've been trying to tell people on the internet the whole time. Like, if you physically tear down these engines apart, the JDM setups all have big port heads within the EJ205, like 02 to 07 range, right? So if you, now knowing this, if I was going to say, hey man, you got a GC8 with a swap, you're going to buy an EJ207 or EJ205, which one would you pick?
EJ205?
Yeah? Why?
Because I can like open up the heads more.
You can open up the heads more. That is technically true compared to this one, right?
Well, yes.
But so what I'm getting at is I would say yes. I would also pick the EJ205, depending on what you're going to do with it.
Yes.
Stock for stock, EJ207, of course, is going to outperform the EJ205.
Yes.
By far. It's got a bigger turbo, better cams. The heads are built differently. But the casting being the same, let's say our goal was a 450, 500 horsepower setup. Well, we're going to have to build the heads. Well, EJ, that's debatable, but let's just say we're going to be doing a basic build where we're doing cams, valve springs, and short block we're going to be building. Like, for an EJ207 that costs $3,500, you could take an EJ205 that costs $600 to $1,200. Take all that extra money that you saved, and you could essentially build this one and save a lot of money at the end of the day, right? So anyways, we're kind of going on a rambling spree right here right now, but the fact of the matter is, when we're looking at these ports, they are very similar, if not the same. I'm trying to look at them right here, and man, they look the same. This one's a little bit harder to tell because there's a big black hole in that thing's dirty, huh?
Yes. But when I did look at when he said, like, guess which one's the biggest, I did definitely think, because it, like, when I did this, I usually do these with my hands. You could tell, like, it does look bigger. And I also started looking at the grooves, like, how it went in more. Like this is more flatter. This is more, like, open up. That's how I kind of saw, like, it was bigger.
Yeah, this portion right here. But if you were to take, like, a intake gasket,
mm-hmm.
and you were to put it on, this one right here from the very top side would probably be close. And I think that they port this purposely like this, where it's opened up on the top, and then it kind of goes in smaller, right? Heads are just designed that way for that, you know, as you know, if you have air coming through here and it goes through a smaller location, it's going to speed up the velocity of the air, if that makes sense. But yeah, that's pretty crazy though, right? A CNC ported head. It's bigger, like it looks bigger, but would you say that, I mean, that's a, I guess this area is a pretty significant difference.
So. Yeah.
It'd be cool to compare a EJ207 or a EJ205 with CNC ported heads, huh?
Yes, it would be.
And then we see how much bigger can you get on these suckers.
Could you go bigger than this though?
I don't think so. Maybe. But that's, I would say it's probably cutting it pretty close. It's a CNC, so they've designed that way to work it out that way. So.
But could you make like, with like the 2.5, like could you make the same kind of power if you were to use a, like these heads, but could you make more power or same amount of power, but just using this, but it's more cheaper to build in my opinion.
Yeah, it would be, it just depends on the vehicle.
Oh, okay.
I think like the, if you're doing a Forester STI, then obviously it'd be best to keep that engine inside of it, or, you know, so you're using the B25 heads. Putting an EJ207 inside of a Forester is a little bit more complicated.
Oh, okay.
Putting this engine inside of a JDM EJ207 setup also would be a little bit difficult too, but engine to engine comparison, the biggest difference with this one right here is that this is a 2.5 liter.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so the heads, I think if you were to build heads, I think if you were to build heads, CNC port them, chamber match them, and put a 2.5 liter with these heads versus a 2.5 liter with this, I think this one would breathe better than the B25 heads.
Oh, okay.
So, but yeah, a little bit more of the complicated hybrid builds and things like that. But yeah, for this right now, we'll go ahead and call it a day for this video here. Appreciate you guys watching. Hopefully you get something out of it. You know, we really just wanted to compare the heads. Version 7, Spec C version 8, B25 from a Forester STI, and just good old EJ205 heads right here. Yeah, if you guys have any ideas on like tech tip videos or anything like that, put it in the comments and we'll do what we can to make it. Appreciate your guys' input and just ideas in the videos. Makes things easier for us and more fun because it's what you guys want to see. Arigato!